Hey, Brie. What are you doing?
Hi, I'm getting baptized.
Yay! Everybody's here to support Brie. Because everybody loves Brie. Everybody say hi!
Hi!
Special and important day. And it was so important that I didn't feel like we needed to wait 2 more weeks. Because God's doing some amazing things in Brie's life, and we appreciate y'all coming to be a part of this. This is a day of celebration. Brie, this is a big deal. And I just want to let you know kind of the significance of what happens in this moment. We don't get baptized to get cleaned up, even though we're baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of our sins, washing our sins away. We get baptized for 3 reasons. To get our sins washed away. It's an open declaration that we're a child of God, and it's spiritually our adoption into His family. So, when you come out of the water, you're coming up into what Jesus called being born again. You're being born again into a new life, which is pretty huge. Everything you carried with you is gone, and everything from this point on is brand new. The enemy's gonna mess with you still. It's not a perfect day, but everything that was no longer is. So, I'm gonna baptize you into Jesus, and when you come up, be excited. We're going to party with you, all right? So grab your nose and then grab your wrist, and I'm going to lean you back. In Jesus' name, I baptize you into this family. Are you damn?
My mascara running.
No. Yeah. Waterproof.
Waterproof.
This is awesome, y'all. Y'all should come in the water. God bless you. I'm so happy for you. So happy.
Hey guys, it's Brie, and I kind of wanted to talk about my journey, what I've been up to the past few months. If you guys are a long subscriber of mine, you know that I share everything with you guys. I am not what you call a very private person. I kind of wear my heart, my life on my sleeve, and I've been vlogging my entire life. Oh my gosh, we're coming up on 5 years. Can you believe that? And almost every week for 5 years, I've said what I've been doing, and I have shared my childhood with you guys, breakups, happiness, birthdays, holidays. Every part of my life is on the internet. And this is a new, very big, substantial part of my life. So I wanted to share it with you guys. About 4 months ago, I started going to church. And I have mentioned before that I was not a religious person. And I connected with my very good friend from high school. Her name is Amanda. She felt the need to call me. Oddly enough, we hadn't really been in touch for 10 years, and she felt the need to call me and ask me to go to church, which I kind of did that moment where you look at the phone. They always do that in movies. I find people always look at the phone. Why are you looking at that? The person you don't, whatever. So Amanda asked me to go to church, and I was like, girl, I will never go to your church. Never, never, never. Well, let's flash forward to I walk in her church, and she said, it's different. I love my church. My church is so fun. And I just sort of gave her that sideways glance like, church, fun, what? And I went one Sunday with her at her demanding request, and I walked in, and I felt something. And I didn't really know what that feeling was, or I was just like, oh, this is kind of weird. But I went with her, and I had genuine fun. I had a blast, and then I was kind of like, took that step back for a moment. I'm like, what am I doing? I'm having fun at church. What is this? And I genuinely liked all of the people there, and I think the people at my church were such a driving force for how much I enjoyed it. And I have changed. I do things differently. I think differently since I started going, and I can't describe it. I don't think there are words to really explain what. And I understood what Amanda was saying, and I am so thankful. My friendship with her has completely grown, and I am so close to her. And I have girlfriends. It's crazy. If you guys watch my videos throughout the years, you will notice that very rarely have I had chick friends. I have a few, and you guys have met them, but I was never a girl that had a lot of girlfriends. And in the last few months, I feel like some of the chains that were holding me emotionally, spiritually, and physically in my life, a chain that I had, is gone. And I started not only attending church on Sunday, but I started going to small groups, attending a life group, and it has changed my life substantially. This church and the people there are phenomenal. Everyone has a story, and people kind of, I found like-minded companions and people that wear their life on their sleeve the way that I do. And I had never met people like that before I went to this church. And I wanted to share with you guys that I got baptized, and I wanted you guys to see it and see the people I went to church with. Now, here's the true story. I did not invite anybody to come to my baptism. My small group that I attend knew about it, and it is the Barca family. And I knew both sisters growing up, went to high school with them, loved them, and I've gotten to know their family through this church, and they have been amazing. So only my small group knew about my baptism, and I walked in the doors, and there were so many people there, and my heart just, I couldn't take it. I was so overwhelmed with love and support. How many people showed up just to watch me go underwater, you know? And in all honesty, when I was heading there, I was like, I don't know what to expect. That's been my thoughts throughout this whole church thing. I didn't know what to expect. I was a little apprehensive and nervous, and there was a big part of me that thought, all right, I'm gonna go underwater, and that's gonna be it, and nothing's gonna change, but I'm gonna have to wash my hair. And y'all know that's a huge task, because I have a lot of hair. But I went under that water, and I felt something. I felt lighter. I don't even know how to describe what I felt, but there was something there. And these are feelings and emotions that I have never felt before. And I think I've just been given a new perspective. And I feel like, I don't know, I don't want to get holy roller on y'all, because that's not me. But this church, my pastors are amazing. I can tell them anything about me, like literally anything, and they're not judgmental. They approach every situation with so much love, and they have completely had an impact on my life. And I don't even know how to repay that or say thank you. I don't know how to thank Amanda for getting me involved in this world. I mean, when she met me, I was in a very sad, broken place, and I have genuine friends that love me and respect me and appreciate my presence in their life as much as I appreciate them in my life. It's amazing. So I want to invite anyone, if you are in the New Orleans area, please come to church with me. Come say hi. Come worship with me. This is a totally different experience. I had been to churches when I was younger, and it's nothing like that. I'll have the information in the bottom bar. Come visit. It's wild. It's so much fun. And thanks for watching, guys. If you want to follow me on Instagram, I post pictures and all kind of fun stuff about my church on Instagram, because I want to share that with y'all. I have such a blast, and I kind of want, even if you're not in the New Orleans area, you can come with me kind of through pictures and fun stuff. But thank you guys for watching, and please give this video a thumbs up, share it with people if you know anyone in the New Orleans area and you're watching that are looking for a church or looking for something like what I have found, this extreme sense of community and love. Come, it's really cool. And I know I sound like a total, like, what language is she speaking kind of person, but it's something that I just love. I look forward to it. And I am not a morning person at all. Like, you can ask anybody that knows me. I am mean and I don't talk in the morning. And I am so tired. I'm always kind of a sleepy person. I'm tired right now. But I never wake up on Sunday morning tired. It is like some magical thing. I wake up excited, refreshed, and ready to go. And that was going to be the main thing holding me back. And something happens to me Sunday morning. I wake up and I am excited about the day. And I go and I see some of my favorite people. And it's so cool. So thank you guys for watching this video. Share it with your friends. Send a like, comment below, and follow me on Instagram and Twitter. See you next time, guys. Bye.